About Faces! This is the show that's the mirror of America. The show that reflects the comedy and drama of daily life. In your face and in faces all about you. And now let's meet the man who knows all about faces, Ben Alexander!
What a real thrill. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. No sergeant of police ever met a handsomer group of suspects, believe me, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, all you smiling faces, and welcome to our show About Faces. And since it is about faces, let's go out into our studio audience and look at some of them. How about this face? Well, that looks like a man who isn't sure whether he wants to be here or not. About this face? Here's a face that wants to be seen on television. It's Donald Morris, who wants to say hello to his daughter and three grandchildren in Union, New Jersey. Incidentally, you might check. Your granddaddy thinks he left the iron on when he left home. And here's a face. How about this one?
Oh!
See, she didn't come to see about faces at all. She thought this was the Dick Clark show. And now, time to find a face in the news. Someone who has done something that made headlines. So let's turn our camera on today's face in the news, and here it is. Whose face is this? Take a look at it. Everyone in the audience, if you recognize it, don't say a word, because I'm going to ask someone out there in the audience who it is. How about a hint, Mr. Face, if you will, please?
Well, about 21 years ago, I stared out at you from every newspaper headline in the nation.
Boy, you really did. Mr. Face, you stared out not in our nation, but in every nation. And now, let's find someone to guess who the face in the news is. How about that lady our camera searched out right there, Tom?
Yes, ma'am. What is your name, please?
Gladys Ferguson.
And where are you from, Gladys?
Detroit, Michigan.
Well, now, Miss Ferguson, without any help from any of the persons around you, tell me the name of our face in the news or what he's famous for, if you will, please.
You can take a guess.
Yeah, but I'm sure I don't know unless he's a...
Take a wild guess. Any guess at all?
She says she thinks he's a news commentator.
A news commentator. Well, the first correct answer is right. Hers may be right or wrong, but we'll have another guess a little later on, and we're not going to tell you what the answer is right now because our at-home viewers are going to play right along with us, and we want to give them a chance later on. Ladies and gentlemen, Hollywood attracts the most beautiful and glamorous women in the whole world, and we're happy to have as our guest today one of the most glamorous women, not only of Hollywood, but of the whole world. And here she is. Ladies, get ready to yell, because here comes the one and only Zsa Zsa Gabor. See? I told you were in for surprises. Miss Gabor, it's a pleasure to have you.
Oh, darling, call me by my first Zsa, please.
Your first Zsa? If I called you by your first Zsa, I don't know how I could get back in the house when I went home, believe me.
Oh, then call me by my beau Zsa.
Zsa Zsa?
Yes.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Zsa, you're just radiant today. And, you know, when we published in the papers that you were going to be on the show, we had letters and wires, and people want to know so many things about you. Why don't you just start them off with one of the things they didn't guess was about this outfit. What are you wearing?
Oh, this is just a simple day dress. It's sort of café au lait collar. It's a French dress.
It is?
And I'm wearing... Oh, I don't know if it photographs. It makes me look fat, I think. I hope not.
Oh, it doesn't at all. It makes you look beautiful. Don't you think so? Don't you think so? Zsa, you've been kind enough to accept my invitation to be my guest to play Place the Face. We're going to show you someone out of your past.
Oh, darling, why must you show me somebody out of my past? Show me somebody out of my future. Who cares about one's past?
Well, we haven't thought up the game to play with somebody out of your future yet, but we may. You know, some of the questions that I know the ladies would like some answers to from you, Zsa Zsa, because you are certainly the most glamorous woman in the world. Do you mind just lifting your veil?
All right.
That's fine.
I thought it's more elegant with the veil, but I don't think the boys can photograph me like that.
Well, you look so beautiful in it that you're taking their mind off their work, actually, is what you're doing, Zsa Zsa. Let me ask you just two questions that I know that all the gals looking in would love to know. How long should a girl know a man before she considers marriage? What do you think?
Well, it depends on the man entirely, I think. Sometimes it's very wise if you marry him the same day because he might not propose to you next day.
And something that used to happen to me a lot, and I never knew how the girls really pulled it off, but what do you think, Zsa Zsa? If you have one beau and then you see somebody else you like a little better, how do you get rid of that first beau?
It's terribly difficult to get rid of a beau. Right now I have about 8 in my collection. But you should keep them for a rainy day. You never know which one you want any, at least me. I never can make up my mind.
Well, you're going to find out the face that we have out of your past to show you in just a moment, but
my
right
past,
now...
My past? How dare you talk about my past?
Well, you know, we thought of having one of your husbands, your ex-husbands, but we didn't think we could afford it.
My ex-husbands are rather expensive. I couldn't afford them either.
Wonderful. Zsa Zsa, right here, before you meet the face, we're going to pause for an important message. And, of course, you know in television, an important message means the commercial, and that means money. Do you mind?
Of course I don't mind. The commercials must make money. Do I get anything off it?
You
out of it.
Certainly do.
Aye. Many people say this is the gun that won the West, and it certainly helped in the hands of the right men. But I'd like to tell you of another breed, the men who built the West, like Tom Brewster. We call him Sugarfoot. Sugarfoot believes in law and order rather than violence. Mild-mannered and peace-loving, but not the kind of man who can be pushed around.
Who did it?
Come to think of it, Sugarfoot.
I did.
Because when the chips are down, he can get as tough as the worst of them. And in the romance department, well, you'll like Sugarfoot. He brings a brand of heartwarming humor, adventure, and two-fisted action that's double-barreled entertainment for all the family. See him every other week on ABC TV.
On we go with a mouth face and lovely Zsa Zsa Gabor here to play Place the Face.
I must say the commercial was divine. I love that.
Wasn't it? It makes money. Now we want to show you a face out of your past. Watch very closely while we open the frame, please. Very good-looking young man. Take a look. Now, before you say anything, Zsa Zsa, we want our announcer, Tom Kennedy, to tell everyone at home and our audience here just who Mr. Face is and how he figured in your past. Just watch while they listen.
The Face is Bruce Cowdery, a released milkman for Arden Farms Company, and he supplies the Gabor household with all its dairy products.
You have 3 minutes in which to guess this man's identity. You may ask questions to be answered only yes or no. And, Mr. Face, wouldn't you start us off with a clue, please?
Well, after we first met, you left me a note, which I still have in church.
I left you a note?
Mm-hmm.
I thought wise women never write any notes down.
Oh. But apparently in this case you wrote something. Do you
must
remember that?
Must have been terribly young then.
Why don't you ask him?
Where was it? In this country or in Europe?
It was in this country.
Mm-hmm. I left him a note.
You left him a note?
Jesus.
It must have been very important because I can tell you this is another clue. After he read the note, it changed all his plans, Zsa Zsa.
It did?
Mm-hmm.
Quite.
I never thought that I write notes like that.
Well, you go on and ask him a few questions, and I know you'll hit on something.
Are you a director?
No.
Well,
he directs his own activities, of course, but he's not a director in the sense of motion pictures.
You are American, yes.
Right.
I hear that. I met you in this country. Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Oh, there's 1 minute up. I might tell you. You have 2 minutes yet to go.
Now, don't scare me.
That's all right.
Do you raise horses?
No.
No horses.
When he first went to work, he followed one.
He followed a horse?
He is now mechanized, but when he first started this job...
Job. You're a postman?
No.
No. That's my dog.
Oh!
Take him off. Maybe Mr. Magoo will recognize it. This is Mr. Magoo. Do you know him?
Apparently not.
You know him too. Well, then I must have seen you recently because Magoo is only 2 years old.
Well, now, he gave you a question not answered yes or no, but he did give you a clue there. He has seen Mr. Magoo.
Hello.
Would you like to give her another clue, Mr. Face, please?
I never come empty-handed.
Oh, that's a nice man.
I always think...
You.
Well, of course. Now, 2 minutes have gone by. We have 1 minute left, Judge.
You're coming to my house?
I have, yeah.
You come to my house?
Mm-hmm.
You deliver something?
Right.
You deliver something.
Now, let me give you a...
Do you deliver my furs from the storage?
Right.
No. And now, what else could be
let
exciting?
Let me give you a clue that may help you. He says he never comes empty-handed. I can also tell you this, Judge, that when he leaves, you always give him some little memento. To take along with him. He never leaves empty-handed.
Well, I should remember a man like that whom I give mementos and letters or not.
Well, you don't exactly give it to him, but at least he leaves with something.
Leave with something?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're not the exterminator.
Uh-oh! Our 3 minutes is up!
I know who he is.
Who it is?
He's a milkman.
Exactly who you are. Would you say that again? I think there was so much applause we couldn't hear it. Holler again.
Well, it's a little bit of a dirty trick. I'm not the regular man there. I'm a relief driver.
But you met me. And when did I leave your note?
Oh, that was 6-7 months ago.
And what did she say?
I probably said, you are too expensive.
Also, she said to you one day, it's nice to have a man around the house,
yes,
didn't she?
She said that.
Well, you helped me with something, didn't you?
That's right, some luggage.
Oh, yes, I remember. And that's it is nice to have a man around the house.
Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
You want to tell her your name, please?
Bruce Cowdery.
Bruce Cowdery.
Thank you, Bruce. Are you coming up to the house again?
Oh, yes. I'll be up there in my garden closet.
You'll be well shaved, too, because we have for you a Ronson shaver, Mr. Cowdery.
Okay.
Thank you very much
thank
for being
you.
Our guest. Thank you, Jodia, for being a wonderful sport. And before you leave and I walk you out to your car, I just want to say that we have to pause again for a very important announcement. This means a
what
commercial.
What are you going to sell
this
now?
This means money.
What are you going to sell, though?
Just what?
The West at its wildest brings you Wyatt Earp at his best.
Put yourself together.
Wyatt Earp, brave, courageous, and bold. Long live his fame, and long live his glory, and long may his story be told.
Wyatt Earp, the law, now riding herd on the worst town in the West, Tombstone, Arizona.
Give me that gun, Johnny.
Wyatt Earp's new adventures, new dangers, new troubles. Wyatt Earp, the man, women find as unpredictable as the men who fear him. For brawling, battling excitement, see Wyatt Earp tangle with Tombstone, the toughest town of all. Everyone in the family will enjoy riding into this world of Wyatt Earp's greatest adventures every week on ABC TV.
Faces. I don't know how I can explain this perfume at home when I get there. Before we take another look at our face in the news, Tom, how do we stand at this point?
Well, Ben, our first lady here, Mrs. Gladys Ferguson from Detroit, says she thinks our news face is a news commentator.
Well, let's take a look at our face in the news. And you know, Mr. Face, your act of daring was hailed by the whole world. Isn't that right?
Yeah, except for a few U.S. government officials who frowned on what I did.
I see. Well, now, there's a very important clue. Don't anyone in the audience tell a soul, because I'm not going to tell you anything until the end of the show. But now, who do we have to guess the identity there, Tom?
Ben, we have a lot of oohs and ahs. I'm going to ask this gentleman his name and hometown.
George McFall, Detroit, Michigan.
All right, George, will you tell me who is Mr. Face?
Sportscaster.
A sportscaster?
Yeah.
Well, we're working on the sportscasting and broadcasting business right now. I can't tell you whether it's yes or no, but a little later on in the show, we'll reveal who it is so our at-home audience can play along with us. And incidentally, let me remind you that it's the first correct answer that wins. In just a moment, our camera will focus on a determined face. But now, if you will, let's take a look at this.
This is Balboa Bay, where Philip Marlowe lives. An hour and a half from Los Angeles, and half that to San Diego in Mexico. Quite a spot. But then Marlowe's quite a guy. Raymond Chandler wrote several novels about him, and about 25 million copies have been sold. Marlowe's been seen in motion pictures and heard on radio. It's not an overstatement to say he's the best-known private detective of all times.
He's off in a blaze of bullets. Philip Carey as Philip Marlowe, setting an action mark for the others to shoot at in this thrilling series on ABC TV. When there's a beauty in distress, Marlowe lends a hand, or even a couple of arms. When there's trouble in store, he's usually on the receiving end. So if you're looking for suspense, see Philip Marlowe every week on ABC TV.